In addition to the general and page setup and columns tabs in the format settings, you'll find a rows and totals tab. The rows and totals tab is going to give you access to set up the various spacing and underlining for totals and sections within a report. You can set the particular row to hide a heading. So if you've got, say, current assets, you don't want to show current assets, you could hide the heading for that section. You could choose to center the heading in the heading column, so that's that first column. You can set a number of blank lines to appear above a given section. So let's say you wanted current assets and fixed assets to have some separation between them. You would be able to say, I want to put, you know, something like one line through nine lines above the fixed assets, which would come below unbilled receivables after the total for the current assets level. You can see they're each tabbed in to give you an idea of the separations. You can also set whether or not you want to have a page break after a given section. So let's say you wanted your assets to have a page break before it moved to liabilities and equity. You would just check that box for the assets section. Or if you wanted to split current assets, fixed assets, intangible assets, etc., you could set a page break there. If you want to hide the totals for a given section, so maybe accounts receivable net, you don't want to show the heading and you don't want to show the totals, you just want the accounts from accounts receivable and the accounts from allowance for doubtful accounts to be their own thing, you could hide those totals there. You can set whether or not there's going to be a blank space above, which is slightly different than a blank line. It's going to give you a blank area though, and still have generally the same effect. And you can also choose whether or not to hide a separator above there, which gives you just a little bit of spacing above the totals. You can underline your totals, set how many underlines, either none, one, or two for a section's totals. So for instance, accounts receivable net does not have any underlining, while the major group, current assets, and the assets, the very major there, are going to have some indicators that they are important subtotals. And then you can choose whether or not to show the currency emblem on every row or the totals